ahead and hot reload. Okay, so I have done a hot reload, as you can see over here. And now I see that the address has been updated. So instead of this one, instead of this text, I see this text. But of course, this is not what you want. In real life, you don't want user, hey, refresh your app again and again. You cannot do that. So you want it to be updated automatically, immediately. Okay, so we'll see how to do that now. Okay. Well, now one of the ways to do it is to, because I'm using Getx. Well, now Getx has a widget which is called GetBuilder. Okay, like this one. Now currently my app is wrapped around GetBuilder. This page is wrapped around using GetBuilder user controller, and from user controller actually I get all this information because the user information is retrieved from the database and saved in this controller. So now the controller print out this information. Okay, all right. And now because it just wrapped around user controller, so I see user information like DLN, the phone number, things like that immediately. But no, address, actually this one is done by another controller, which I say location controller. Well, actually this is my controller. Okay, so they're being dealt with two different controllers. But if I see my card page, my account page over here, I see I have only one controller. So that's why even if you updated this information immediately, just now, but it didn't get updated immediately because you didn't wrap around your widget using your location controller or whatever the controller you're using. So the idea is, so if you have two different controllers on the same page, you need to use both of them to be able to get the updated information immediately, okay? Because in the whole page, I have just only one controller here, but the information is coming both from user controller, okay, and from location controller. Once I said location controller is responsible for showing or manipulating or working with the address, things like that, okay? All right, so that's why actually we are getting error, okay? Yeah, so, now there are a few ways to do this. Either you can wrap this section, which is this column, around GetBuilder location controller, you're good to go. Or I can just wrap around these two widgets, which is gesture detector and the other gesture detector, using GetBuilder and my location controller. Okay, so right now it's not wrapped around, it's just a conditional check. So if you want to get immediate update, you should wrap your widget around your using GetBuilder. So this, in this case, it would be nested GetBuilder, and we are going to wrap the nested widget using GetBuilder. So it works for the both principle. Okay, so let's do it. Now here, I could do one thing. Let's go ahead and first write here GetBuilder. Okay, now GetBuilder over here, I want to use location controller just for these two widgets. Okay, so here I do location controller. Okay, and here I do builder, and I'm not going to use any instance of the controller here though, so I'll just keep it empty over here. I'll put a comma over here so that the error is gone, and then I have to return, because within builder you always have to return regardless it's Getx builder or Flutter's own builder. Okay, it really doesn't matter. Okay, so now here I have this logic, so I'll move it inside my return statement over here. So let me enlarge the screen. Okay, now I'll put it here. Okay, now I need to do a bit of change over here, otherwise we'll still have error. So instead of this one, actually I could do here, if If the condition is true, then do this. Otherwise, else do that. Okay. Else. And here I have this one. Okay. All right. And I don't need this. Now we are missing our return statement. So here we could put one return statement. And over here we have another return statement. And after each return statement, you should put semicolon. Otherwise, it will get error. So here is the same thing. Okay. So now let me collapse it so that we understand what's going on. So right now I'm wrapped around location controller. I wrapped this widget around location controller. So whenever things changes inside location controller, we'll get immediate update on the UI. Okay, as you can see, this is my location controller. All right, and it ends here, I guess. Let's see. What is this? Oh, this is for builder. Okay, that's fine. All right, so now here, what do we have here? So now for builder itself, they're becoming nested one inside the other. Okay, now our widgets like this one, they are also nested widget, because why? Inside column, single child, scroll view, and expanded. So we can use GetBuilder inside nested widget, like in this situation. So the idea is you can use both nested widget and nested controller, which means GetBuilder, at the same time. All right, okay, that's it. But now it's time to go ahead and test this, whether it works or not. Okay, so what I will do, I'll go out and log out. Now I want to create a new user over here. So I'll do dylan@deepestack.com. Okay, now here I would do 123456, phone number 123456789, really doesn't matter, and Ahmed. Okay, all right, so now we'll go ahead and sign up. We signed up. Now we come over here, we see the new information that I've filled in. Now here, what I have here, now it's falling back to this condition over here. Okay, now what we'll expect, we'll go ahead, fill it out, and then we'll expect that it updates automatically the page without refreshing it. Okay, once again, here I am. So here, this is our location controller. You can name it anything. You need one. Otherwise, if you just use the default one, which is this one, which also means most probably nothing. So it won't update automatically. So you need an instance of this controller, even if you don't use it. Okay. All right. Now, anyway, so I don't have any information in the database. So even if I do hot reload, as you can see, nothing is there. So now what I will do, I'll go ahead and fill in the address. And over here, say, I say Dhaka, Bangladesh. Okay. All right. Now here I will save. And okay, once I come over here, you see this page has been refreshed automatically, not like the earlier time. Okay, so what we want is that, I mean, it should be updated automatically. Okay, you don't want user to wait and refresh and then update it. Okay, so you can do it using GetBuilder. And if it's necessary, then you can use nested get builders like the way I did over here. Okay, if you need a bunch of controllers, you can just use one inside the other, and it should work. Okay, all right, hopefully it makes sense. Thank you.